Hi friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is Saksham Gupta, first year triple E undergrad at Bitswilani Pilani campus. And friends, I feel really grateful and I have a lot of gratitude feeling for all of you as you have supported me in my channel growth, and I have reached 250 subscribers quite recently only. So big thanks to you friends for that. And friends, in today's video, basically I have a new guest with me and we will be continuing the episode 2 of the series of choosing bits over IITs. So friends, one thing which I want to make very clear to you that these videos are not a kind of college flex. These are just to provide your perspective as to why a particular guy or girl choose BITS over IITs and what's their perspective about it. Because a lot of the aspirants, including you, might also be facing the same issue, because you might be able to clear IIT as well as get a good seat in BITS also. So it might become, you know, a topic of good discussion, and you know, you will need to have a great thought about this topic, whether you want to choose BITS or you want to choose IITs. See, both the colleges are perfect in themselves, but just it's like, you know, which cake you want to eat. Of course, both are sweet only. So it's just to provide a perspective. It's not about a college flick. So just don't take it the other way around and just enjoy the video and feel this perspective and use your own brain. Of course, never just follow anyone blindly. Listen to the people who chose IIT over BITS, that why they choose IIT over BITS, and listen to these guys like these who chose BITS over IITs, and then find out that what suits you, what's your strength that will just outshine in the particular institute, and that will help you take the best decision. So friends, without wasting any much of your time, let's start the video. Hi friends, so this is Sarthak, a first year CS undergrad at BITS Pilani, and Sarthak, I would insist you to please give a short intro about yourself, like your hobbies and from where you belong to. And where you do coaching and all?
Hi, sir. Sarthak Shah. I am from Udaipur, Rajasthan. I took coaching from Allen in 11th, 12th, and Rezo in 9th, 10th. Okay. So, also, in hobbies, I like playing chess. I love playing table tennis. And also, I am into gaming, esports stuff. And I like mainly problem solving. I like solving puzzles.
So, were you a dropper or you just came after 12th?
Came out of 12.
That's very nice. So what was your rank in ITJ and your score in BITSAT?
My rank was 938 in JE advanced and BITSAT marks are 394.
So of course you were getting computer science at BITS Pilani. So but what were the other options available to you at that point of time?
So there were many options available. Majority I'm telling that I considered. Most were IIT Bombay Mechanical, IIT Kanpur Electrical, and IIT Guwahati MNC, and IIT Indore CS, and IIT BHU 5-year CS. That these five options were main.
So why BITS Pilani Computer Science?
Mainly for country, one by one I will react there. Yeah. IIT Indore CS, alumni based, because it's a new IIT. I know that this is a IIT and it's a good IIT, but alumni is not that much and it is important.
Yes.
So I reject it. For mechanical and electrical in IIT Kanpur and Bombay, I do not like these subjects. Mechanical also a little bit, but electrical I don't like it. I researched on the topics and I, as from my 12th experience, I did not like the electrical subjects. And switching there from electrical to tech related fields, well, in the placements and stuff, I think it would be extra. Efforts and it will be a waste of time. Many things will be a waste of time. So why to look for that? And for considering for IIT Guwahati MNC, I like maths, I know, but I research more on the topics of MNC, and I like mainly problem solving maths, in which you have to apply your love, in which you use your mind generally and not exact level correct never. गुवाहाटी एम एन सी मैंने इसलिए रिजेक्ट की मिल ली क्योंकि मुझे मैंने टॉपिक रिसर्च की थी उसमें एम एन सी के बारे में क्या है तो मेनली जो मैथ्स थी वो स्टैटिस्टिकल मैथ्स है सॉर्ट ऑफ मोर टूवर्ड्स दैट नॉट सम एल्जेब्रा एंड स्टफ सो मेरे को वो पसंद नहीं आ रहा था क्योंकि मुझे पहले से वो पसंद नहीं था और मैं भी वापस फील्ड स्विच करना मुझे लगा कि ऐसा अच्छा नहीं है मतलब नहीं है उसका दो चीज पढ़ के
Yes.
So, इसलिए मैंने ब्रांच को प्रेफर किया सीएस
सो इट सीम्स दैट यू रिसर्च अ लॉट अबाउट यू नो द कोर्सेज which you might be studying in the electrical or mechanical or computer science. So friends, to condense what he said, that if he's like comparing to the old IITs or the elite IITs, which we generally refer to, like the IIT Bombay, IIT Kanpur, so he was getting electrical and mechanical, but he ditched them because he was not like into the subjects that were being offered. Even the Phoenix branch electrical, as he said, that he was just not interested in the courses which were taught, and he was more into, you know, the computer science problem solving part. And talking about the new IITs, which he saw, or the perspective of Sarthak is that in new IITs, he didn't find a good alum base, and for him alum base is also important, so you can also consider these facts. Of course, so that's an important thing, that alum base is also compared as the second gen IITs have a slightly not so better alum base, but of course definitely a good alum base. So Sarthak, coming to the next questions, is that if you prepared for BitSat separately?
You know, because I researched the paper, how it is that, so it required mainly speed and knowledge of almost all topics. So my speed was already good, so I did not prepare anything separate for the check.
So any mock test which you gave before exam?
Before exam, just as saw the questions, not give a particular mock test in fixed time limit. I just saw the question and I thought that mainly they were formula based.
Yes.
So I just revised all the formulas.
And what would you like to say about the English and the reasoning part? How should aspirants prepare for that?
For reasoning, my reasoning was I feel like that it was already good, so I did not prepare. But you should prepare for reasoning. It is hard, some little bit hard. And for English, I think it doesn't. I did not prepare, but I think it does not matter.
Yeah, even what I feel, friends, is that English, you cannot do it in a you know, 1 or 2 months, because it's a gradual process. You have learned over the years, like how fluent you are in English, how many novels or how many newspapers or whatever you have read or not. So that depends on the you know, a lot of years. But of course, you should definitely go for the reasoning part, that you should preparing, because there's a chapter specified. Even I have a video in which I've told that what chapters carry important weightages. So you should definitely go through that, because you can then score handsomely in those topics. So that's a very important topic. And friends, moreover, like he had a rank of around 900, but as I told in my previous episode also, that you should be giving the mock test. Even to be honest, when I went for BitSat, I just gave one mock test, because I was pretty sure that something good will happen. But in the mock test, I was scoring around 320 and 325. So I was not hoping a lot of marks. So I was considering approx 330 and all. But when I went to the examination hall, it was such a good experience that I took my score from 320 to 355. So, and I hope that was possible, because I was carrying a bit of confidence that yesterday only I gave a paper. So however so intelligent you are, or howsoever you are scoring well in your exams, you should definitely give at least one mock test. That will elevate your score massively, because many of my friends are there who are in IITs. They are in IIT Bombay and IIT Delhi. But they didn't score well in BitSat, approximately 300 or 310, just because they didn't even look at the paper once, and they were just going, you know, blankly. So that can cause a major issue, because even if your potential is up to a level X, then to perform up to the level X, you need to know, you need to do something in the back end. So that's very important, to perform to your potential. So that's a good answer, Sarthak. And now moving on, Sarthak, what I want to ask you, that what unique things you felt about BITS Pilani? Like, what are the unique things you saw at BITS Pilani?
Firstly, 0% attendance. I love it. I rarely go to class.
Me too.
Meantime, I explore many things. I have explored many fields. So I just love 0% attendance. I don't want to go to below 7 hour class and stuff. You get much free time.
Yeah.
And work on many things. Like, many projects are also where you can work on your startup, you can work on projects. So that's the main thing, and also the startup culture. So
definitely the startup culture is quite talked about. Yeah, a lot of my seniors are also very enthusiastic. So it's a very important thing to consider, friend, the college culture, and that you will only come to know by speaking to the ones who are studying there. So definitely keep this in mind, that how is the college culture, like if it is a coding culture over there, or entrepreneurship culture over there. So whatever suits your personality or your liking or your passion, then that should be an ideal choice for you to make. Okay, Sarthak, so do you regret being not called an IITian? Like, you know, that there's a social hype of being an IITian. So how far do you think that it's something you have left out in life, and that you might regret in your life?
Mainly socially, I would say that mainly the yes, I my neighbors will come and my relatives have come, and they don't know BITS Pilani, and
Yes.
they compare me to people with in IIT. With IIT tag is not the only thing in the lab, and it does not matter that much. So I think, matlab, for your parents, in your outer happiness, it would matter, but it won't.
Yeah.
If you ignore them, just.
Just focus on whatever you choose the decision. Yeah, it's definitely like
खाने पे ध्यान दो तो कुछ
correct.
फर्क नहीं पड़ता है वो.
Correct, 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 correct. It's just like being happy or showing that whether you are happy. Well, in no terms I'm saying that people in IT are not happy. Just the fact that what you like he loves CS, computer science. So even he ditched IIT Kanpur Electrical, which is a very respectable branch over there, and an elite IIT of IIT Kanpur. But definitely, when you do something which your heart says, then you feel self then your self-esteem also booms, and you never feel regret. You never regret. So that's what I think, and you should always do like what you want to do, because later on you will have no one to blame. And if something doesn't suits you, if you will be disheartened, then that would just kind of then that would just hurt you only. So I really appreciate your decision of not choosing IIT, because you were not getting your preferred thing over there and choosing BITS. So that's a really commendable job you did, Sarthak. And now, any advice to the juniors you want to give?
Mainly for while choosing the college, they should listen to their heart. They should explore all the things, all the options they have, and research more about the college they are choosing. It's necessary. Matlab, people don't consider that part as important, I think.
Yes.
Matlab, but it's very important. You should start after giving JEE also. You can, after a week or so, you know what your rank would be nearly. So you should start exploring things, which is important part. And also, matlab, don't consider other hard things like matlab, what someone would say or what others are saying. Just listen to your heart. If you will regret, then it would all be in you. You will not say that उसकी वजह से ले लिया, उसके कारण ये हो गया. तो
Correct. See, after listening to you, I can deduce one thing. So I want to say this, like IIT is a phenomenal college. They are seriously incomparable. But sometimes you don't get what you like over there. And just because of social hype, you stick to that IIT tag. But later on, you might regret it. You can listen to your friends, listen to your seniors, like what they are saying, because they are into that field. And someone who has taken his or her own decision is likely to be much more happier and can give justification about what he did in life. So it's always better to compare on the basis of like what Sarthak did. Like he compared on the basis of what the course structure is and what the future opportunities is, and not just going in the herd. Of course, in no way I'm saying that in no way even I and Sarthak are trying to say that IITs are any less. They are definitely incomparable. But of course, you should always go where your heart says, because ultimately you are the one who is going to experience all the things. So it was a lovely talk with you, Sarthak, and I'm really happy that you came onto my channel and gave some insights to the aspirants, to the future aspirants who might be in confusion of choosing BITS or IIT. So now they will be able to take the decision wisely. So friends, I just want to say that do not listen to a conversation blindly or any other's conversation blindly. Listen to everyone, I will say, but always take your decision wisely and by your own self. Never fall into trap of listening to somebody else or what anybody else might say if I went to some college or some particular X college or some particular Y college, because they want to be there when you will start regretting. You will only have yourself to regret. So I just wish that that day time might not come to you. So both are perfect colleges, just I want to say that. And if you are getting preferred branch of your choice in IITs or BITS, you may go to any college. Both are perfect, and you will definitely not regret it later on. So thank you guys, and thank you Sarthak for connecting with us. It was a really heartwarming experience to connect with you. Thank you.